Hi, I'm MG, host of Life Unexpected. Today we have Marianne Kuharski of the Billboard people, you know, Prolife Across America. So stay tuned for an exciting show. Hi, I'm MG, host of Life Unexpected. Today's show is not about you, and it's not about me. It's about all of us taking personal responsibility when a little one's life is unexpected. In studio today, I have Marianne Kuharski. Hi, pleased to meet you again.
Hi, MG. Very nice to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Well, our pleasure, our pleasure. So what really matters?
Human life. I mean, that's what we're all about, it's been 40 years. This is the month coming up, or the anniversary is coming up, that will be 40 years. And as far as the pro-life movement views this, nothing has changed. We will keep on working and never quit as long as anyone's life is threatened. And of course, the child in the womb, there's no one more vulnerable, no one more helpless, no one more defenseless, no one that, and really out of all humankind, that is more dependent upon you and upon me to do something to help them so that they will have a chance for life like you and I have had. So that's what really we're all about with Pro-Life Across America, is to broadcast the truth and offer alternatives and assistance to those in need.
Now, when did your organization start?
This is our 24th year. I can't believe that it's been that long. My previous experience had been I'd worked in politics. I'd worked with women with crisis pregnancies for 25 years. And it was becoming more and more frustrating to see more and more women coming in who'd already had previous abortions, or knowing that while we were off, you know, helping one or two women, that thousands every day, 4,400 babies a day die by legal abortion, over a million a year. So what could we do to get that truth out, to let someone know that there is an alternative, that the baby has a heartbeat as early as 18 days from conception, that the baby has brain waves, that the baby has fingerprints 9 weeks. Most abortions occur between the 9th and the 12th week. How can we let people know that little one already has unique fingerprints, never to be repeated again? So we thought, when we first started 24 years ago, we didn't have any money. Our sign was very simple, almost primitive, black and white sketch. And it just said, a baby is a baby is a baby, heartbeat, 24 days. And that shows you how long ago that was. The technology said 24 days. Now we know it's as early, if not earlier, than even 18 days from conception. Well, the first boards went up. We saved our money. Pro-lifers gave to us. We put up the first, well, we had 42 billboards in all that first year. The first board wasn't up 2 weeks when we got our call. There was no hotline, by the way. We did this from my living room. Mm-hmm. And we got a call from the Life Care Center then in St. Paul and said, you should know that this woman was scheduled for an abortion but came into our office and said, I can't drive by that ad on my way to work every day and go through with the abortion. Mm-hmm. And that's when we realized that God was using this media, this billboard outreach. I never thought, I'm a housewife with a bunch of kids and now grandkids, and I never thought I'd be a champion for billboards. But I realized that some people may not be watching television, they may not be listening to a radio ad, they may not receive the paper or see a little ad in the paper. But all of us at one time or another are riding buses or walking or riding bikes or in the car, and we do see billboards, and there's something about that larger than life message that hits home with people, that can penetrate the heart. Mm-hmm. And so from that 42 billboards the first year, now we've been escalating. We've now changed our name. We started out with Pro-Life Minnesota. Mm-hmm. We changed our name legally years ago, back in the 1990s, and now we're Prolife across America. Every year for the last 5 years, we've done 6,500 billboards a year, and we're in 40, sometimes as many as 44 states with our messages that have, and we hear from people all across America saying that it's changed their opinion, changed their heart, or in some cases actually saved a life. Just 2 days ago, we had a woman in Planned Parenthood waiting for an abortion who, because of a close friend and because she had second thoughts, the friend saw our billboard, called for help, and we got her the help that she needed through the Life Care Centers. So that's the miracle of God using this technology to help others.
That's amazing. Thank you. Any other amazing stories to share? They're so uplifting.
You probably have thousands in your back pocket. Angie, I could hold up a picture of just about everything and say, oh, we saved a baby when this happened, or we saved a baby when this happened. We had a counselor who called from Marshall, Texas. I didn't even know we had a board there. It seemed to be kind of a leftover that, so the billboard, the outdoor ad company put one in that city. And a director of a pro-life clinic there called and said, you need to know that you saved a baby's life. And the story she told was that the woman had come in the day before, demanded an abortion, and left very abruptly, accusing them of false advertising because it was a women's clinic and she assumed that she could get her abortion there. And they assured her that, no, we've got alternatives, we'll help you through your pregnancy, but this is one thing that we don't do. And the next day, the woman came in again and said, you know, I'm pregnant and I understand that you'll help me. And so the director said, well, were you in here yesterday? And the woman said, well, yes, I was. She said, well, did you have a different plan? And she said, well, in fact, I was. I was planning on having an abortion, but when I went home and told my sister, she put me in the car and drove me over to this great big sign. Oh. And when I saw a picture of the baby sleeping and read that the baby already had a heartbeat, I knew I couldn't go through with it. Mm. So, you know, there's something about that larger than life when we see an ad and we realize that that's truth and it's impacting us. Mm-hmm. I mean, we even notice our ads, if you look through the history, you can catch us online at www.prolifeacrossamerica.org. We don't just address the pregnant woman. We don't just say pregnant need help, because the statistics show that 90% of all women who get an abortion did it to please or protect someone else. Mm. So maybe it was her boyfriend or her parents or her husband. Sad to say, I had a woman sobbing, calling on the phone not long ago saying, I'm newly married. I got married a year ago, and I just found out I was pregnant and told my husband, and he told me to have an abortion, and I didn't know he didn't want children. So, I mean, there are dramas like that that we try to help people through as well, and we've even had to find people places to live if they've been, you know, tossed out of their home. But we try to direct the billboards towards anybody, so that even truck drivers on the street might penetrate through to them what that simple ad says. In fact, speaking of a truck driver, that was another very tender call I got one day from a man who called, and I could hear all this machinery in the background, and he said, I'm an over-the-road trucker. And he said, I'm up on, he named the interstate that he was on, and he said, is that ad true? And I said, I don't know, what did you see? And he said, well, is it true that the kid has a heartbeat at 18 days? And I said, yes, it does. A preborn baby's heart begins to beat as early as 18 days from conception. And it was a long pause, and I could hear the wheels, you know, of his vehicle, and he said, well, he said, my girlfriend's pregnant, and I told her to take, this is his words, take care of it, get rid of it, we're not ready for this. And I said, well, now you understand that your baby's heart is already beating. Mm-hmm. I said, I bet you're going to call her and tell her not to go through with it. And I said, and I bet you're going to help her. And it was a long pause. I just prayed, Lord, help me with this. Long pause. And he said, yes, I am. So, you know, I think God gives men the natural inclination to be protectors and providers. And I feel bad when women rush off thinking, well, we should do this for the person I love, when oftentimes if we gave them time or enough information, they would do the right thing and be a provider and a protector, if not for themselves, at least allow the child to be place for adoption where the child would have a life and a future. Mm-hmm. And in fact, we hear from men on our hotline now, the longer this issue of abortion goes on, the more people call for help who've been involved with abortion, those who've not only had abortion, but fathers who forced daughters to have it, mothers who forced children to have it, as well as boyfriends. We had a man who said, in fact, I'll credit Catholic, it was Catholic Radio in this instance, he said, I haven't been to church in 10 years. And he said, I'd like to go back to my church. It's Christmas. I hear Christmas music. I stumbled on this Catholic station, but he said, I can't get right with God until I get some kind of counseling because he said he paid for two abortions. And then as he got talking, he was quiet. He said, I didn't just pay for them. He said, I pushed and pushed and pushed her until she got them. So those are the kinds of calls. We're here to save souls.
Right.
You know, it's not us, it's God. We're just his arms and his legs and the telephone on the other end. And what we try to do is direct them to the help that they need. So we're nonprofit, non-political, tax deductible, of course. And 94 cents of every dollar, I don't get a salary. I've been the director for 24 years. I take no salary. We do have some employees, but if you put all of their salaries together, it wouldn't equal one living wage. So we run like a mission, and we're here to do God's work and just plant a seed, tell the truth, and offer alternatives through our hotline.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Well, thank you, MG, and thank you for letting us tell our story in this community. And we hope that other people out there who may know someone who's pregnant, or they may didn't know that there was alternatives, or they want to talk to someone about adoption. We had a college student who was living in a state, didn't know anyone. She was a young girl, and she found herself pregnant. She called for help. We got her in touch with medical services, and she made an adoption plan through an agency right here in the Twin Cities, in fact, Holy Family Adoption Agency. So miracles do happen. It's just being aware of who we are and what we do and working with us. And we would ask if, of course, I would love to have support, so if people can send us donations, that's how we thrive. But I'm convinced that prayer is what really fuels us. So I would ask all of your viewers to please pray for Pro-Life Across America and our work.
Absolutely, absolutely. With that note, we're going to take a quick break, and perhaps you viewers out there can take this time during your break to say a prayer for Pro-Life Across America.
Great.
We'll be back.
Life Unexpected is produced in Minneapolis, Minnesota by the volunteers of St. Michael Broadcasting. For more information, visit our website at www.stmichaelbroadcasting.com.
She's sucking her thumb.
She's so beautiful.
That's our son.
She's got my nose.
With new advances in medical technology, we now have a window to the womb that reveals your unborn baby, who looks a lot like you, just weeks after conception. Now we know an unborn baby is a human life. See what we've been missing.
Hi, I'm MG. Welcome back to Life Unexpected. Visiting here with Marianne Kuharski, the Billboard People. We're talking about revisiting the challenges of our world by putting out billboards about the pro-life movement. So what are your thoughts about the acceptance of the billboard? You mentioned people like to see them if they're thinking and changing their mind about abortion. What about people who do not want to change their mind about abortion?
Well, I just heard from one yesterday who sometimes they'll argue, and sometimes we get unpleasant types of calls and threatening calls. I take it all. I have to say the majority of people, you know, there's something tender and touching when you see a picture of a little baby, even this, now this little guy, it looks like he's a biker. And I actually had some people who paid to have this up in the upper UP, Michigan. It's a picture that says Born to Ride. Cute. And a baby's arms appear 28 days from conception.
Aww.
And it's a wonderful little message. So even people who aren't necessarily with us for the first time, they're, you know, they can't help but smile. Everyone relates to a child. It might be a niece or a nephew or maybe one of their own children or grandchildren, or, you know, even pro-abortionists love their own children. Mm-hmm. And so this is what the issue is all about. In fact, I had, when we first started using babies, I got a call from a couple of people who were very pro-abortion, and they'd say, you know, this is the sneakiest, most underhanded, mean thing that you pro-lifers could ever do. And I said, what do you mean? And they said, well, using little innocent babies. And I said, well, isn't that what the issue is all about, is babies? And, you know, these babies get us to think backwards as they're telling us that their arms developed before birth, or that they could dream, you know, weeks and months before birth, and that their heart was beating weeks and months before birth. And so these babies are getting us to stop and think. And in fact, not too long ago, I got a call from a reporter who asked me my comment because the atheists were putting up a couple of billboards. And they were using babies' faces. And when they called the atheists to ask why did they use babies' faces, they said it was to mock the work of pro-life across America. And so the reporter asked, what did I think of it? And I said, well, imitation is the highest form of flattery. And tell them if they get anybody who calls with a crisis pregnancy, to be sure to send them my way. We would like to help them. So, you know, you have to take some of these good things in stride. We know that the opponents, the devil in particular, doesn't like us to do good things. And there's nothing more beautiful, more positive, more tender and touching than seeing the innocence of a little tiny baby. And we've heard that from many, many sources of people saying that I wanted to ignore your message, I wanted to ignore your ad. I had a call from a woman who said, she was just in tears, and she said, I can't have this baby, I can't go through with this pregnancy, but something made me call you instead. And by the way, MG, you know what I think that something was? I think it's because our pro-life people, not only do they finance what we do by donating to us, mm-hmm. but I believe in my heart of hearts that the great majority, if not all of them, are praying mm-hmm. For us, for those billboards, that perhaps the next person that sees that billboard will call for help instead. Mm-hmm. And I really do believe that that's why people call for help. We recently did not too long ago, we did 900 billboards featuring babies with Down syndrome mm-hmm. with a simple little message. One little guy was all by himself. He had carrot red hair. His name was Ricky. And he was the seventh child adopted by a young family who were very pro-life, and they heard about this little guy and wanted to adopt him. And this little guy here has two big brothers, and the message was, our brother is a blessing. He has Down syndrome. Well, these billboards appeared in 42 states. We, as I said, we did over 900 of these billboards featuring babies with Down syndrome. We never had so many calls thanking us, including from people who said they were not on our side, but they had a niece or a nephew or a younger brother. And in one case, it was a woman who said, I'm very pro-abortion, I'm very feminist, I don't agree with anything you do. They warned me to have an abortion myself because my baby might be Down syndrome. And she says, I had a perfect little four-year-old girl, and then I had our little baby boy. And she said, you know, your ad is right. She said, he is the sweetest, most beautiful. He is a blessing to us. And of course, I teased her and said, well, I think you really want to donate to us. You should be on our side. I was, you know, I believe in conversion, so I want to invite everyone to be part of what we do, because I know that it really is life-changing. God has a way of showing us the beauty of life in all of his creation, the earth, the snow, the sun, the moon, the changing of the leaves. Yeah, well, I said snow because I'm from Minnesota, and we have to love it otherwise. I don't know why we're here otherwise. But yes, God speaks to us even through the snow and the cold and the ice. But to me, the way he speaks to us the most beautifully is through his innocent human life. And mm-hmm. this little baby sleeping, held in the hands of a mother, and a father, could be more beautiful. And get our message across that we need to cherish all life from the moment of conception to natural death.
How do you choose the messages that are on the billboard? Do you have a panel of people?
I would love to tell you, MG, that it was. We have these geniuses that all sit around this big conference table, and yes, we do have. We have our team that we think we have what our theme is going to be for the next campaign. We have series of campaigns, mm-hmm. billboard campaigns that we do depending upon our funding. So when funds are lacking, then we can't put on a campaign. But basically, and we'll pray, I make no bones about the fact we have someone coming from the billboard company. In fact, she's gotten used to the fact that we have our Blessed Mother. She's the patroness of our work. Mm-hmm. So we have that. We have a candle. We do pray before we begin our work. But I have to say, it's really the Holy Spirit that intervenes. There's so many times we sit down at a table and say, now, this campaign is going to emphasize this topic. And the next thing I know, things are coming out. We have babies, and all the babies that are featured on our billboards are all babies of donors. So they have to be, their parents have to be supporting our
financial
work.
Donors.
Financial donors, and doesn't have to be big finance, can be anything. But we want them, this is our way of saying thank you to them, mm-hmm. and it's our way to show the beauty of our babies. You know, why should we pay for studio babies when our babies are equally, if not mm-hmm. more beautiful? Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. those are, but it's amazing to us, and we all look at when the billboards are finished and the designs are ready, then we give them to billboard experts who are graphic designers to finish off the topic. And we're always amazed that it's really the Holy Spirit that chooses the topics.
Mm-hmm. And speaking about donors, Mary Ann, I know the last time we were together, we mm-hmm. were together in my mother's kitchen.
Yes.
Because my mother was in her 80s.
Mm-hmm. I remember your sweet mother.
Yes.
We had one thing, big thing in common, we were both Italian.
Right. And she was thinking about her last will and testament and yes. wanting to give some financial donation to a pro-life organization. Mm-hmm. And she met you, discussed yes. the possibilities, and sure enough, she did.
She absolutely did. Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I'm not saying it to glorify her, but perhaps to give viewers the idea that donations can come in the form of a last will and testimony, because if people do not financially donate, it's not going to happen.
That's right.
God gives us money to share, especially with organizations like yourself. So, and I love my mother, and I know she would be delighted to know I mentioned her name on television, but it's true, especially an older person can consider that.
Thank you, MG, for saying that. Sometimes we really don't know if we're going to be able to make it or not. As I mentioned, I don't take a sale. We run like a mission, so mm-hmm. 94 cents of every dollar goes into the ads that people are seeing. But oftentimes, this spring was a good example where we were ready to go with something and we had to postpone it for 5 months because we didn't have the funds. Mm-hmm. And every once in a while, we'll get a last will and testament of somebody who's given something towards us, or people send us donations in honor of somebody's birthday, someone's anniversary. And by the way, we send them cards in their name every time someone does send, or a memorial for someone who's died as well. So mm-hmm. we just think what a wonderful tribute and what a wonderful way for that person to live on, knowing they've helped an innocent, vulnerable baby have a life.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my mom felt so good about it.
Well, we're very grateful.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So as far as your concerns, what in our last few minutes of the show, what would you like to tell the viewers?
What I would really like to do is let people know that we are a people of hope and a people of faith and people of life. Mm-hmm. And if we don't send a message, we almost have to make sure that we target who we give to and who we pray for. The other side will take care of the donations. I always say, let the pagans give to that, but let us give to our church, to our missions, to our Catholic schools, and especially to those who can't help themselves through the pro-life movement. So I would ask for prayers daily for adopt an unborn baby through Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Bishop Sheen recommended that. Mm-hmm. Adopt Pro-Life Across America. We thrive on prayer. And then, of course, if anyone can give, no donation is too small or too large, mm-hmm. We depend upon that. We can't continue this outreach. It is a media outreach to those on the streets. We had a young mother who was expecting a baby, sitting on a bus, planning an abortion, changed her mind because she saw an ad mm-hmm. through the bus window. So whatever help, we're very grateful.
How about your contact information for the viewers?
Thank you. Prolife Across America, www.prolifeacrossamerica.org is our website, or they can call us at 612-781-0410. That's 612-781-0410. But basically, Prolife Across America is on the web. Mm-hmm. No hyphens and no dashes.
Oh, that is just fabulous. Just fabulous,
thank
Marian.
You,
how do you keep it up? You're just so, I could just feel the energy bouncing right off you. You must do circles around your family. You're just amazing.
Well, my pastor says it's a good thing we've got her busy.
Well, I really appreciate you being so busy,
taking
the time today to come to Life Unexpected.
Thank you very
much. And I'd like to thank the viewers, too, for staying involved and watching our show, because with this added information, hopefully you can pass it along and make the nonviolent solution a part of your life for someone you know that has a life unexpected. Have a wonderful day.
Life Unexpected is produced in Minneapolis, Minnesota by the volunteers of St. Michael Broadcasting. For more information, visit our website at www.stmichaelbroadcasting.com.